Hi students, today we are going to discuss about hashing. It's a very important concept for searching. Okay. So majorly hashing function using for searching. But before going to actual implementation and procedure of hashing technique, first, you can recollect the information about another searching methods, like very familiar searching methods so far we have discussed. One is linear search, another one is binary search. So linear search is a method to search the element in sequential form from starting of the position to ending of the position until to find the element or key in the list. The linear search, the best case, best time complexity is big O of 1. How you can say that time complexity is big O of 1 means, let us take example. In this example, take the list of elements, take the size 5, take the elements, these are the elements are having the list in the given index position. This is array. Suppose if you want to search, we want to search the key element is 10. Key element is 10 from the list. How many steps to take to search the element in the list? From the in the list. Okay. So it is only one step is required to find out the key is 10 in the list. Because of the linear search is starting from first position onwards. So the first position itself we are find the searching element, so that is the time complexity is order of 1 or big O of 1. That is the one step is enough to search that particular key in the list. So that is advantage also of linear search. And what is the drawback, what is the problem of the linear search? Okay, let us take same example. My key element, that means the searching element is 20. How many steps to take to search entire the list of the elements from starting position to ending position? From this example, the linear search start from the first position, next go to second position, next go to third position, next go to fourth, then last position. That means the last position we find the searching element in the list. So that how much time to take? Suppose the key array size is 5, so that is it can take 5 steps. Okay. Suppose the array size is n. Suppose the element is present or placed at last position, how much time to take? Big O of n. So this is the worst time complexity of linear search. Can you understand what is the drawback, what is the advantage? So linear search is advantage when the searching element is present at initial position, so it can take only one step to find out that element. At the same time, if the element is placed at last position, it can take that number of time to search to reach the last position. Suppose if you want to search the element number, key element is 25. From this example, there is no element is 25. Even though the linear search will be starting the searching from 0 position to until the last position of the list. But the result is key is not found. Key is not found. So how many steps it can take? Size of the list. So this is the worst time complexity of the linear search. This is the best time complexity of the linear search. Okay. Linear search is also called as a sequential search. Sequential search. Or continuous search, continuous, or ordered search, that means can go one after another. Okay, various names which is comes under the sequential search. Okay, so that is the linear search. Then go for the binary search. What the advantage of binary search compared to the linear search? If there is drawbacks having the binary search, so how those overcome drawbacks of binary search by hashing. Okay, next go for binary search. Next look at another best searching method is binary search. Okay, so binary search, so before applying the binary search, one condition need to satisfy. What is the condition? The element should be in order. Should be in order. So then only the binary search is the best. If there is no elements in order, the binary search is not applicable to that list of elements. Okay. If you want apply the binary search, first we have to check out the list of elements in order. If it is in order, then the binary search is implemented on the list. Okay. Suppose take example of this one, 10, 15, 2, 3, 20. This is the list of elements. Can you apply the binary search directly? Can you apply the binary search directly on the list? No. No, it is not. There is no binary search for unordered list. Okay. The prerequisites of before searching the binary search, apply the binary search, is the element should be in order. Okay. First, make the list of elements in order. So then we can apply the binary search. Then only it can possible to apply the binary search. Next, here also take the best case is order of 1. The best case is order of 1. Why? Why it is order of 1? Suppose the binary search searching position is starting from mid position. So this is the starting position of the binary search, not zero. It is the starting position is mid position of the list. Then check the key element. Suppose your searching element is 10. Unfortunately, your searching element is 10. First, the key is search is present at mid position or not. This is the array. If it is match, so then one step is enough to search that element in the list. So that's why the best case also order of 1. Then what about the remaining element? Suppose the key element is 15. How you can search? Whatever the key element you want to search, first it can place that mid position, then check the condition of mid position value. If the value is greater than the mid position, go to right side. If the value is less than the mid position, go to left side. So that is the general principles of the binary search. Now the 15 is the searching element. We are starting at the mid position. Mid position is 10. 10 is not equal to 15. Then which side I want to move to search the element? Right side, obviously, because of the condition is like that. Okay, we can move right side, then at any position we can find the element. And another case, if the searching element is 2, again we are starting from mid position. If it is less than or greater than, if it is less than of 10, then go for right position. So at any point after few steps we are finding the searching element. So but the difference is the linear search, we can search entire list from 0 to 1, but here we can minimizing the steps or optimizing the step to search the element into the particular position, only right side or left side. We are not at all to search all the elements. We can search only sub portion of the list to find the elements. Okay, so this is the binary search. So this is some better than the linear search, so that can time complexity, worst case is order of or big O of log n. So very it is a lesser time compared to the linear search. So linear search will be take, this is the greater than this one. So that's why binary searching time is less than to linear search. So here also having some problem, it can take some move some position to find the element in the binary search also. But how those problems are overcome by hashing. So now we know the clear picture of searching, linear search and binary search. Linear search having the worst case time complexity is order of n. The binary search worst case time complexity is order of log n or big O of log n. Now why can't to reducing the time with the constant? That means why can't to take every searching element is one attempt? Is there any possibility? As hashing function is doing same thing, if want to search any element, it can take only one step to search the element. Let us discuss what is the beauty of hashing in the case of searching. Okay, next we're going to discuss about hashing. Let's look at the topic hashing. So far we are discussing about the various comparison between linear search and binary search. Now we move for hashing. Hashing technique is used for searching. Hashing is one of the method in searching like linear and binary. So one thing you have to observe here, what is mean by hashing? What is mean by, or what is the importance of hashing? Hashing is a method. Hashing is a method or function. Hashing is a method or function to delete the elements in the list. Okay, this is the meaning of hashing. Okay, hashing function responsibility is if any element we can give to the hash function is placed appropriate position in the list. In the linear search, no method is take care about to insert the elements into, place the elements into the stack. So now the function is hand over the entire thing to make the searching time is optimized, maximum is constant of 10, that is the order of 1. So let us explain with example. So how async function is done.